Happy Tuesday. It is the 18th of December. I want to say good morning to you. Happy, happy Tuesday. God bless you. Welcome this morning. We greet you in the marvelous, wonderful name of Jesus Christ. I want to say great morning to everyone. Come on, if you're dialing in, if you're connecting with me, let me know where you're watching from, where you're tuning from. Welcome to this I Pray broadcast for Tuesday, the 18th. Great morning, everybody. All right, I'm going to give a few minutes for us folks to dial in. Welcome this morning. If you're watching, you're tuning in. Pastor Jay here, and we greet you this morning. As always, great morning. Welcome this morning, everyone. I see you connecting. I see you dialing in. Thank you so much for sharing the videos. Bless God for the shareholders. If you're watching today, welcome. Good morning, Jamarco, John. As you tune in and connect this morning, welcome to this broadcast. This is the 18th of December. I want to welcome everybody. I want to say good morning to you. Again, it is another morning and we're live. Welcome. I welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you're tuning in, let me know where you're watching from. Good morning, James. Good morning, Don. Don, Sean, Evelyn, everybody that's tuning in today, welcome. We greet you in the marvelous, mighty name of Jesus Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall rejoice. You should rejoice and be glad in it, right? And so we want to welcome everybody. If you're watching on our branch Facebook page, share that video. Good morning, Karen. God bless you, family. Everybody that's tuning in, we welcome you into this day. Stay with us. Don't hang up. Good morning, Stephanie in Tampa. I want to say good morning to all my cousins and family members all over the East Coast. Good morning, Hugh. Bless you, sir. Again, welcome this morning. Wherever you are today, we greet you in the marvelous name of Jesus Christ. It is another Tuesday, and it is a blessing to be with you. If you're at work, on your way to work, in the car, at the gym, still in the bed, walking around in your robe, wherever you're at, good morning. If you're watching this at a later time, we send greetings and blessings to you. Again, this is Pastor Jay. I welcome you into this day. It is Tuesday morning, and we're glad that you're with us. We pray that you have been blessed and encouraged by these Monday through Friday live broadcasts. We need to know if this has been a blessing to you. Let me know if you've been encouraged. If you're watching and you haven't been saying anything, thank you for tuning in. If you've been blessed, you've been encouraged, this has been a great devotional for you, or a great food of thought, we need to know if we're reaching you and if you are encouraged. If you don't like me and you keep coming back watching, thank you for joining me once again. We love you and we bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But if you are tuning in, wherever you're tuning in from all over the world, we greet you today. And I'm going to jump right into this just for the sake of time, but welcome everybody. God bless you. If you are a fivefold gift, a leader, we bless you and we welcome you and we're praying for you. Thank you so much for tuning in to this weekly broadcast, Monday through Friday, right here. Jermaine T. Johnson, the Branch Worship Center. The Branch Worship Center's YouTube page. Subscribe, like, follow, commit, save, all of that stuff that we do on social media. But this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. If you haven't heard it yet, we love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. And what we want you to do, tell somebody that you love them today. Call somebody, share with somebody, give somebody an encouragement today. As you're on your way to work, this is the greatest day of 2018. Why? Because you're still here. Hallelujah. All right. Father, we thank you and we bless you for this morning. I thank you for the great work that you are doing in this day, Father, as we begin it. I pray right now for our partners, friends, family members. We pray for those that are tuning in and watching us and connecting with us. Lord, we pray as we come in agreement. You said we're two or more touch and agree, there you are in the midst. So I thank you for the law of agreement that says, Father, you are with us. and you will never leave us nor forsake us. So, Father, we thank you for being with us in this day. Lord, when we look to the left, you're there. When we look to the right, well, you're there. And when we look ahead, you are there. So I thank you, Father, for being with us today. And so, Father, we want you, we need you, we expect you in our life today. Lord, somebody needs you in a great way today. And as we pray, Lord, we lift up your name. We lift up the name of Jesus, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess and declare that you are Lord. So we declare you are Lord of this day. You are the Lord of our circumstance, situation. You are the Lord of our families, friends, neighborhoods, cities, and even the nations. You are Lord of America. And so, God, as we pray today, we lift up families. Lord, we lift up the children. We thank you, Father, for moving and being a blessing in young Peyton's life. We thank you, Father, for healing her. And Lord, we thank you for her recovery. Father, I pray this morning for Quan. Lord, we thank you, Father, for his recovery. And Lord, we thank you, Father, for touching these children, healing them. We thank you for those that have prayed and are praying with us. Lord, we lift them up today. We thank you for these precious children. Father, we remember them, we cover them. And Lord, we lift up children all over. Father, we lift up young children. Our children, as they go to school today, we cover them today. We cover children that are in families. Lord, I even want to pray today, children that are in foster homes, children that are in that have been abandoned, that are in orphanages, that are in foster homes, that are in systems. Lord, we lift them up today. Some of us may know some children that may be separated from their family, their children. We pray for those children who have parents that are incarcerated. Lord, I lift up children today. Lord, we pray for children that have been bullied in school. We lift up our sons and daughters. And Lord, I thank you for the health of our children. I believe that was Jackie. Somebody sent me something, and we just lift up children today. I want to pray for children that are in the children hospitals, that are in the foster homes, even children that are in juvenile detention centers. Lord, we cover sons, daughters, young children today. There are so many. If you know them by name, we just lift them up right now. And I pray for your child today as they go to daycare, elementary school, middle school, high school, some that are home for college. We pray for those that are home for college. We just cover the young people today. In Jesus' name, Father, I pray for young people who may be rebellious, rambunctious, out of control. God, I pray that you would touch their hearts. I want to pray for a young man that I met on Sunday. His name is Roscoe. He might not even know I'm praying for him. But Lord, in Jesus' name, touch his heart, touch his mind, touch his body. Lord, we thank you, Father God, that you have blessed Roscoe and you blessed his life. And we remember him this morning. And we thank you, Father, for total restoration for Quan, for his body, just for his mind. Lord, we lift him up. We pray for his family and those that are interceding for him. We cover him now in Jesus' name. Father, I pray right now for this day, Lord, for those that are preparing to travel. Lord, we lift up leaders, fivefold gifts, pastors, apostles, bishops, prophets, evangelists, lay leaders, deacons, elders, doorkeepers. Lord, I pray for the body of Christ today. Lord, we lift up those that are serving, preaching the gospel and bringing the message of Jesus Christ from week to week. We pray for strength in families. We lift up pastors and their wives and their families and their children. I lift up PK kids today. And God, we lift up again those that are contemplating. I heard a story on yesterday. We prayed. And there's a young lady who is a teacher, encountered a young man who came to her on yesterday and didn't want to live. And she was able to intervene. Her name is Candace, and she may be watching. But she was able to intervene as a teacher in the life of some young person, a young man that wanted to commit suicide, that was talking about not living. And she was able to assist him and expand the love that was shared on yesterday. And so we bless God this morning for teachers that are loving students. And we pray for anyone today that as you come in contact, that you would experience the discernment and the revelation to know how to extend love into somebody's life that may be contemplating suicide. And so we thank God for Candace in the prayers and whoever you were yesterday that you don't even know who you came in contact with, but you might have intervened in someone's thought or someone's assignment or thought or purpose to take their life on yesterday. And we thank God for that young man, well, in his school, by his teacher, that was able to love him just where he was to help him. And so we bless God. That's a miracle, right? That's a miracle. You might not think it's a miracle, but I thank God for people like Candace, hallelujah, and teachers like Carla and Nicole and Georgia Prep. Come on, there are people that are praying and interceding and intervening for young people every day, and we thank God for you today. I just want to honor all of the administrators and teachers today. We bless you for your commitment and your sacrifice. Your labor is not in vain, and your ministry is greater than any pulpit because you touch the lives of children. I want to speak to the teachers that believe and pray. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. I see your prayer requests, and we thank God for you. Let me jump right into this. I'm going to pick back up on where I left off yesterday. Yesterday, we asked, what are you wearing? And that was a good teaching, but I want to continue on that. And with a thought this morning, not just where are you wearing, but I want to know what garment are you putting on today? The garment of what garment? If you putting on a garment this morning and you know what you putting on today, you might be putting on the garment of praise. You might be putting on the garment of warfare. I don't know. What garment are you putting on today? Today, we're going to talk about the garment of. And whatever the question mark is, you fill it in. What garment are you putting on today? What are you wearing? We know that you can put on the garment of praise. If you put on the garment of praise, can I get some praise this morning? Can I get some response this morning? But let's go to Isaiah. Good morning, everybody that's tuning in. Share this video. Welcome. We greet you in the marvelous name of Jesus Christ. If you watching and somebody shared this with you, I am Pastor Jay. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. Good morning. I see a brother on here, Bob. I want to say great morning to all the brothers that are tuning in this morning. Good morning, brethren. Wagwan. Want to say happy Tuesday to you. Good morning, all of the men of God that are tuning in. I thank God for men that are watching me. I'm praying for you, my brother. I'm praying for you, man of God. I'm praying for you. Have a blessed and prosperous day. Hallelujah. Praying for you today. Isaiah 9:6, very familiar passage. Let me read this for you this day as a meditation, right? And then we'll pray out. Isaiah 9:6, it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called the Mighty God." All right? I'm just summing it up. Good morning, Timothy. Great morning to you, brother. Mighty God. I'm just summing it up, right? We know one version might say wonderful counselor, mighty God. All right. And so I just want to touch for a moment this morning as you put on the garment of dominion. The garment of dominion. Tomorrow we'll talk about another garment. I feel like talking about garments this morning. Good morning, Candace. There you go. God bless you. Good morning, everyone that's watching and tuning in. We want to put on this morning the garment of dominion. What am I talking about? Well, in this scripture, we love this because we love to use this for this season that we're in, Christmas, whether you celebrate it or not, whether you put up a tree or not. I don't have time for that. Happy Kwanzaa, happy Christmas, Merry Christmas, whatever that is, whatever it is to you. This scripture says, "For unto us a child is born," right? And this child is born with a garment. I love this because we put so much emphasis on just the child, but not what he's wrapped in. The Bible says he was wrapped in swaddled in clothing. Why? Because it was his garment. That garment represented his dominion. We see here very clearly, it says, and the government, at the time when the government don't know if they want to operate right, shut down, work together, it's so chaotic. See, when you put on the garment of dominion, it represents your government. It represents your authority. And so this morning, I want to encourage you, put on the government or the dominion garment that God has given you. He's given you authority. He's given you dominion. Do you know the garment of dominion begins with your mouth? It comes out of your heart and what you speak. Come on, you can put on the garment of authority, of government, of dominion, just by what you say. The whole aspect. Thank God for Dr. Cindy Trim.
teaching us how to command our mourning. But as you command your mourning, it is the government, it is the garment of your day. It's what you put on. And so when you put on a garment, come on, I said on yesterday, you put on certain garments according to the zone that you're in. I don't know what zone you're in. You might be in the end zone. You might be in the twilight zone. You might be in the happy zone. You might be in the miserable zone. But whatever zone you're in, yes, put on the garment of praise. But I want to encourage you, beloved, put on the garment of dominion. Take dominion and authority over your life. When you put on the garment of dominion, you take authority over your home, over your region, and over everything, your sphere of influence. Are you understanding today? In other words, when you put on the garment of dominion, your metron expands so that everywhere that your feet go, everything that you put your hands to will prosper because of the garment of government, the garment of dominion. Come on, when you begin to take authority and dominion over your house, over your finances, over your situation, over your body, you begin to understand. I'm putting on the garment of dominion so that I can walk in healing. Why did Jesus take 39 stripes on his back? Oh my gosh, 39 stripes was the garment for healing. I might be jumping ahead of myself. Jesus put on 39 stripes. Why? Because it was the garment for healing. Oh my gosh. Are you getting this today? The Bible says the government was upon his shoulder. I don't know anybody that don't put on a garment unless you put on a shoulderless blouse. But most garments are made in the winter to cover your shoulders. Now, what's important about your shoulders, beloved? You're going to love this. Your shoulders are one of the most important parts of your body. Now, it's important that when you put on, why do they put stars on the shoulders of a, oh my gosh, of a general? Why do they give stars and stripes? Come on, my God. You got to understand, your shoulders are where your, come on, are where your affirmations and your confirmations bling the most. Are you with me today? In other words, when people look at your shoulders, oh, it lets you know the garment. It lets you know the capacity. It lets you know, this is a good teaching this morning. Your shoulders, it identifies your rank. Oh my God. Is this good this morning? Somebody say yes. Your shoulders identify your rank. And so when you put on the garment of government, when you put on the government, when the government is on your shoulders, it identifies your rank. Is anybody getting boosted this morning? Can I get a share this morning? If this is good, can I get some hearts? Can I get some amen? I don't know. If you're with me today, just respond to me. Your government is identified on your shoulders. Come on. We like to teach about headship. Yes, it didn't say anything about his head. It didn't say anything about his head and his neck. It says something about his shoulders. What's identified on your shoulders? You got to get that. What's identified on your shoulders determines your dominion. In other words, there's some things you can't sweat. There's some people, come on, when you know who you are, when you know your rank, you don't sweat the small stuff. Let me give you this and I'm going to get on out of here. Watch this morning. Your shoulders are one of the most important. Do you know your shoulders incorporate three bones? It's one of the few places on your body that incorporate a joint with three bones. Now, I want to give you this. Can I give you this anatomy concerning the shoulders? Why the shoulders? The shoulders are all throughout the Bible. The Bible talks about shoulders more than Jesus, right? So listen what it says. I want you to get this anatomy. The shoulder must be mobile enough for the wide range of actions, the arms, and the hand, for the arms and the hands. In other words, your shoulders may be mobile. So your dominion, watch this. What's on your shoulders need to have a wide range of impact. Your shoulders is where your dominion began. The government on your shoulders, the government on Jesus' shoulders gave him a wide range of what his arms and his hands could do. Come on, my gosh. Somebody, can you get this revelation today? When your shoulders have the capacity for wide range. Ah, it does not limit you. It does not stagnate you. And watch this. It determines the actions of your arms and your hands. Come on, some of you, your arms and your hands have been tired, but I want to declare and decree today that God wants to put on you. I'm getting into a teaching that might be ahead of myself, but this is when you understand mantles determine the range of your arms and your hands. In other words, your reach and what that thing that you impact. Oh my gosh, if you want to prosper today, whatever you put your hands to prosper, oh, it determines what's on your shoulder. It determines your rank. It determines your capacity. It determines, oh my gosh, the range of what you're willing to carry. You see, Jesus, what was on Jesus' shoulders was the weight of the world. It was the sin of all mankind. That's why he says, are you ready? Are you really ready to do this? That's why he said, drink of my blood and eat of my body. See, the disciples didn't have the range to partake in what was on his shoulders. Who am I talking to today? I might be giving too much revelation this morning. Watch this. The range. Your shoulders must be mobile enough. One thing that's horrible is a dislocated shoulder. Can I speak to the athletes this morning? One of the reasons why I didn't continue is because I had an experience in my youth of a dislocated shoulder playing. You know, we used to play football on the park, and we used to call it sandlock. Right? You didn't have no shoulders. You didn't have no helmet. And so a dislocated shoulder, come on, my gosh, will hinder your range. And some of us don't realize 2018 might have tried to dislocate your shoulder, but God is going to pop that thing back in place. Oh, my gosh. And watch this. A shoulder is stable enough for actions such as lifting, pushing, and pulling. The garment that God wants to put on your shoulder today, the government that God has given you today, is going to allow you to lift, oh my gosh, push, oh my gosh, and pull. Somebody need to get this today. The garment that you wear today is put on your shoulder so that you can what? Lift, so that you can push, and so that you can pull. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but God wants to lift you up. He wants to exalt you. He wants you to have the capacity to lift up that which has been before you. He wants you to have the capacity to push into your purpose. He wants you to have the capacity to pull. Come on, my gosh. This is a good teaching today. I want you to put on the garment, the garment of dominion on your shoulders so that you, the garment of what? The garment of dominion. Somebody say dominion, dominion, dominion. Because he's expanding your range so that you can have mobility. So that you can have mobility. So that you can be able to flex. Come on. You can't lift. You can't pull. Oh my gosh. And you can't push if you don't know what's on your shoulders. Some of us are stagnated because we have missed the rank that is on your shoulders. Who am I talking? Somebody say, I'm putting it on today. I'm putting it on my dominion. I'm putting on my government. I'm putting on, come on. Can the real government please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Father, we thank you this morning for this word. I thank you, Father, that we're putting on the garment of dominion, of authority. Father, we thank you for the garment, Hobashanta, of government. That allows us, Father God, for stability. Lord, our shoulders are covered, Lord, with mantles of authority. Our shoulders are covered. Come on, we're taking back authority over our life. What the enemy has tried to steal, kill, and to destroy. We declare, Father God, in Jesus' name, we're recovered. Come on, David, I'm going to close with this. I got to stop. David, when he was faced after everything, it's a place called Ziklag. I might be jumping ahead. Ziklag was the place where David put on the garment called the ephod. We'll talk about that garment tomorrow. The garment of ephod, it was a priestly garment. We're going to talk about the garment, the priestly garment tomorrow. The priestly garment. And he asked God a question. Should I pursue? And God said, pursue. Oh, my gosh. When you know what garment you put on your shoulders, God going to cause you to recover all. I'm going to stop right there. Father, we bless you and we give you glory and we give you honor for this word, this revelation and this thought today. I pray for every person that is watching. God, I thank you that you're strengthening shoulders. Lord, where shoulders have been dislocated, have been disjointed, have been out of place. Father, we don't even realize some back pain has come because our shoulders have been out of place. Our spiritual shoulders, the authority that you've given us. Now, Lord, I pray right now that you will cause men, women, children, families, pastors, leaders, businessmen, those that are watching to get back into the place that you have given them, the rank that you've assigned them in. God, I thank you that people are going from privates to lieutenants in Jesus' name, from lieutenants to colonels, from colonels, to generals. Lord, we pray blessings over every person that's watching today, that's tuning in, and let this word begin to establish a garment of authority in their life. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Oh, bless the Lord, family. I see you this morning. I want to say good morning to everybody. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you, Malene. I see you, Carl. I see you, Mercy. I see you, Gail. Good morning, Gail. God bless you. Linda, Pastor Leroy, good morning. God bless you. Let me see who else in here. Thank you so much for tuning in, everybody. Share this video. Be a blessing to somebody. Share the love of Jesus Christ. Tell somebody that you love them. Tell somebody that Jesus loves them. Be a blessing to somebody. Buy somebody lunch today. Good morning, Alpha, Shireen, Cousin Stephanie, Teresa, Miss D, Cousin Jackie. Bless God for my cousins this morning. Sean, Janice, good morning. LaWanda in Columbus, Georgia. Good morning. Karen, Cousin Karen. Lonzo, God bless you, brother. Everybody, we thank you this morning for tuning in. Mark, Felicia, John, everybody, good morning. Shauna Lee, God bless you. Kelly, Mother Young, God bless you. Tara, God bless you. Everybody this morning, let me bless you as I go out. Don, again, good morning, Carl. Deidre, God bless you this morning, Deidre. Hallelujah. Carla, God bless you. We're praying for Quan. Jason, good morning. Ah, Jamarco, bless you, brother. Yes, hallelujah. Miss Denise, good morning, Miss Judy. Good morning, Timothy. Good morning, Nadia and Sean. Everybody that's watching on the Branch Facebook page, Valencia, Candid, Mary, everybody, I see you this morning. Thank you for tuning in. Share this video. I appreciate you. Join me tomorrow morning, 6:30 a.m. We'll be back here tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. And beginning December 31st, Monday, December 31st, we will be broadcasting every morning at 6:30 a.m., Monday through Friday. Monday through Friday, 6:30 a.m. And again, join us on January 8th, Tuesday morning. We're going to have live prayer in live. Join me here, 5 a.m. prayer right here. Don't come, don't watch via internet. If you're in the city, join me for 1 hour of prayer. We're going to have a live breakthrough prayer every Tuesday in January, the 8th, the 15th, and the 22nd. All right, God bless you, family. Have a wonderful day. We will talk with you soon. Bye for now. Shalom.